Unacademy Comp's time to experience something glorious. Unacademy Combat. Compete, crack, conquer.
एक ऐसा चैलेंज जो यूपीएससी सीएससी एस्पिरेंट्स को लाएगा उनके मंजिल के करीब.
Where you put your knowledge to test
and battle it out with the best.
ताकि आपकी तैयारी बने और भी पक्की.
Unacademy Combat is the most competitive gamified contest for UPSC CSE till date. जहां आपको मिलेंगे बेस्ट क्वेश्चंस जिन्हें सेट किया है बेस्ट एजुकेटर्स ने.
देखिए डिटेल्ड वीडियो सॉल्यूशंस टॉप एजुकेटर्स से हर कॉन्टेस्ट के बाद.
लीजिए हर कॉम्बैट को लाइव और पाइए रियल टाइम रैंकिंग्स अमेजिंग प्राइसेस के साथ.
लगातार हर कॉन्टेस्ट में पार्टिसिपेट करें और अपनी रेटिंग्स इंप्रूव करें.
चैलेंजिंग कॉन्टेस्ट्स एवरी फोर्टनाइट और अल्टरनेट संडे. लाइव रैंकिंग आफ्टर एवरी क्वेश्चन. बिग रिवॉर्ड्स फॉर टॉप रैंकर्स. योर पैशन टू क्रैक यूपीएससी सीएसई डिजर्व्स दिस. योर हार्ड वर्क टुवर्ड्स योर ड्रीम deserves this. Fuel your inner fire for the ultimate UPSC CSE challenge. Unacademy Combat. Register now.
Hi everyone. Welcome to today's class. So this is a demo class for all of you. The demo class related to the lectures that I'm going to take on Unacademy Plus. So we are starting a very important course on Unacademy Plus from 7th of December 2020. The course will be on Ancient Indian History. So we are 7th of December 2020 se Ancient Indian History ke upar batches launch kar rahe hain. Aur I'll be teaching these courses, I'll be taking these batches on Unacademy Plus. And today we are going to conduct a demo session for all of you that how we teach in the batches. हम कैसे पढ़ाते हैं batches में. How do we approach the subject and the topics in the batches on Unacademy Plus. That is a demo that I am going to provide to all of you. And we are conducting this batch keeping in mind both prelims and mains. So today I am going to start with religion and philosophy. आज की class में मैं religion और philosophy से start करने वाली हूँ. If you wish to take Unacademy Plus subscription, after taking this demo session, you can use this code Sharma20 to get 10% discount. अगर आपको demo session देखने के बाद इच्छा हुई कि आप subscription लेना चाहते हैं Unacademy Plus पर, तो आप ये code use कर सकते हैं Sharma20, जिससे आपको easily 10% off मिल जाएगा Unacademy Plus subscription पर. ठीक है? Let's start the class then. Religion and philosophy की class शुरू करते हैं. So when we talk about religion and philosophy, we are going to start with the Vedic civilization. आज की क्लास में हम Vedic civilization से शुरू करने वाले हैं. We will study what was the society in Vedic civilization and accordingly we will study the religion and philosophy of that time. तो in my plus courses, I teach with the help of flowcharts. मैं अपने plus courses में ना flowchart और mind maps के help से पढ़ाती हूँ. So it becomes very easy for the student to revise during the examination. जिससे क्या होता है? It becomes very easy, simpler. Topics सिंपल हो जाते हैं, इजी हो जाते हैं स्टूडेंट्स के लिए, रिवीजन के लिए. ठीक है? सो वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद द ऋग्वेदिक पीरियड. हम शुरू कर रहे हैं ऋग्वेदिक पीरियड से. सो व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द ऋग्वेदिक पीरियड, द सोशल लाइफ इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज इट इज आस्क्ड अ लॉट इन जीएस पेपर वन. जीएस मेंस पेपर वन में सोशल लाइफ, रिलीजन, फिलोसफी, कल्चर के बारे में काफी पूछा जाता है in the Vedic civilization. So in the Rigvedic period na, when we talk about social life, it was a tribal society. Society bilkul tribal hua karti thi Rigvedic period mein. It was a tribal society. Tribal society means that the people used to lead a semi-nomadic life. Tribal society ka matlab hai kis tarike ka jeevan jeete the log, semi-nomadic. They were not completely nomads and they were not completely settled down at one place. They were semi-nomadic people. Kabhi kahin chale gaye, kabhi nahi gaye, kabhi kuch samay ke liye jagah ruk gaye. So when we talk about the tribes of tribal society in the Rigvedic period, they were known as Janas. तो जो tribe होती थी ना Rigvedic period की, उसको tribe को क्या बोलते थे? Janas. They were known as Janas. And the chief of the tribe was known as Rajan. Rajan means the king. तो जो chief होता था, head होता था tribe का, उसको Rajan बोलते थे. He had another name also. That was Gopati or Gopa. Gopati या गोपा, this was the name given to the Rajan or the chief of the tribe. Why Gopati or Gopa? Because he used to protect all the cows of the tribe. उस tribe के जितनी भी गाय हुआ करती थी, cows हुआ करते थे, ठीक है? तो उनको कौन protect करता था? Rajan. So because he used to protect all the cows of his tribes, he was known as Gopati or Gopa. Now the chief queen of the Rajan used to be known as Mahisi. These pointers are important for prelims. Ye jo points hai na, ye aapke prelims ke liye kaafi important hai. So make sure that you are noting this down or making this flowchart. So far we have studied that there was a tribal society in Rigvedic period and they used to lead a semi-nomadic life. And the tribes were known as Janas, and the chief or the head of the tribe was known as Rajan, who was also known as Gopati or Gopa because he used to protect the cows of the tribe. His queen was known as Mahisi. Okay. Now, there were conflicts in the tribal society in the Rigvedic period. Ab jo aapka later Rigvedic period, jo mid Rigvedic period hai, usme hamesha jhagde rehte the tribal society mein between two tribes. ठीक है, नाउ द टू ट्राइब्स वर, फर्स्ट वॉज द जनास, दे यूज टू प्रोटेक्ट द काउज. सेकेंड ट्राइब वॉज नोन एज पानीस, दे यूज टू यू नो स्टील द कैटल ऑफ द आर्यंस. तो जनास ट्राइब जो थे ना, उनकी कैटल को, उनकी गाय को, बकरी को, भेड़ बकरियों को चुरा लिया करते थे पानीस. That is why these two tribes used to indulge in battles. इसलिए हमेशा जनास और पानीस के बीच में ना लड़ाई रहती थी. So to get their cattle back, the Vedic god Indra was invoked. तो जनास, they used to pray to Lord Indra to you know help support them in this fight with the Panis. And the battles were known as Gavisti, Gaveshna, Goshu, Gavyat. In sabhi ye alag alag naam hai, these are different names of the battles between Panis and tribes, and these battles were to search for the cows only, and these battles were you know fought between the Aryans and Panis. These are the Panis, and the people of Jana tribe were known as Aryan. Jo Jana tribe ke log the, unko Aryans kaha jata tha. ठीक है, सो दीज आर द नेम ऑफ द डिफरेंट बैटल्स दैट वाज फॉट बिटवीन द टू ट्राइब्स. नाउ कमिंग ऑन टू द पॉलिटिकल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द ऋग्वेदिक पीरियड. व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट पॉलिटिकल स्ट्रक्चर, वी हैव स्टडीड दैट देयर वाज अ किंग एंड अ क्वीन. सो दैट मींस देयर वाज अ मोनार्कियल फॉर्म ऑफ एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. हमने अभी पढ़ा कि किंग और क्वीन हुआ करते थे, राइट, महिषी एंड योर गोपति. सो दे वर द किंग एंड क्वींस. दैट मींस देयर वाज अ मोनार्कियल फॉर्म ऑफ एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. बट एज वी कैन सी दैट इन द लेटर मिडिवल पीरियड, वी हैव सीन दैट द किंग, द पोजिशन ऑफ किंग वॉज हेरिडेटरी इन नेचर. दिस वॉज नॉट सो इन द पीरियड ऑफ Rigvedic civilization. The office of Gopati was not hereditary. Now this is important for prelims. ये आपके prelims के लिए काफी important है कि जो office था ना hereditary नहीं था. राजा का जो office हुआ करता था वो hereditary nature में नहीं था. It was selected among the clansmen. आपस में ही जो you know उस गांव के जो लोग थे वो अपने आप आपस में ही चुना करते थे कि राजा कौन बनेगा. ठीक है, एंड इट इज सेड दैट द पर्सन हु हैड द मोर नंबर ऑफ काउज यूज टू बी द किंग. जो वो यू नो इंसान जिसके पास ज्यादा गाय हुआ करती थी उसको राजा बना देते थे. नाउ देर वॉज डिफ्रेंसिएशन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ वर्ण. वर्ण मीन्स ओवर हेयर कलर. तो कलर के बेसिस पर डिफ्रेंसिएशन ऋग्वेदिक पीरियड में देखा जाया करता था. ठीक है, सो पनीस दे वर डार्क स्किन्ड पीपल एंड द जनास और द आर्यस दे वर फेयर स्किन्ड पीपल. सो देर वॉज अ डिफ्रेंसिएशन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ कलर, स्किन कलर. Now, between Vedic and non-Vedic people, that means the dark-skinned people were known as non-Vedic and the fair-skinned people or fair-colored people were known as Vedic people. Now, in the political structure of the Rigvedic civilization, society was not divided on caste lines. So, you, in a single family, you can belong to different caste. For example, somebody can be a Kshatriya in a family, somebody else in the same family can be a Brahmin, right? So, Rigveda mein ye mentioned hai ki aapka jo caste hota hai na, uske basis pe koi differentiation nahi tha. Aap kisi bhi profession mein enter kar sakte ho, kisi bhi caste mein ek hi family mein reh sakte ho. And occupation was not based on birth. For example, if you are born in a family of priest, so it is not mandatory that you will also become a priest. मान लो कि आप ऋग्वेदिक पीरियड में किसी पंडित के फैमिली में पैदा हुए हो, तो कंपलसरी नहीं है कि आपको भी पंडित बनना है. You can become a businessman, you can become a trader, merchant or kshatriya. ठीक है, and members of a family could adopt different occupations. The father can be a farmer, the grandfather can be a doctor. The son can be, you know, a merchant or a trader. So the members of a family were not compelled to carry out the same lineage of occupation in the Rigvedic period. Okay. So coming on to the family, family ki agar hum baat kare, in the Rigvedic period, family was known as kul and the head of the family was known as kulapa. To jo parivar hota tha Rigvedic period mein usko kul bolte the aur jo head hota tha family ka usko kulapa bolte the. And there was a joint family system. Nuclear families nahi hoti thi, you know. in today's modern time, we have nuclear families, right? Small families. But in that time, we had very joint families, patrilineal system tha. So over here, you can see that, you know, these families together, these kulas, all the families in a village together, they were known as vis or clan. So ye jo kul hua karte the na, maan lo ek gaon ke andar 10 kul hain, to un sabko together hum rakkar kya bolte the, vis ya clan bol sakte hain, theek hai? And they were social units. That means everybody, every family in the village, they were linked together with brotherhood. They had a sense of unity, fraternity amongst them. And women were educated in the family. And they had access to sit in the high assemblies also. Maan lo us gaon mein koi assembly conduct ho rahi hai, to auraton ko ye right tha ki wo us assembly mein participate kar sakti hain. And at that time, they were free to choose their life partners also from any clan, from any family. Kisi bhi family se, kisi bhi clan se, wo apne life partners khud chun sakti thi. Unke paas itni freedom thi. So you can say that yes, open-mindedness in the Rigvedic period we can see. So these are the important terms from prelims perspective that you should know. Pre-Aryans were known as Dasas or Dasyus. Purohit was known as priest. Senani means leader of army. Gramini means leader of village. Sabha means smaller body which was only meant exclusively for the elites. Samiti means broad-based folk assembly. Vidhata means tribal assembly. And Gana means assembly or troop. So these terms are important from the perspective of prelims. Ye jo terms hai na, ye prelims ke perspective se kafi important hai. So make sure that you are noting them down. Now let's understand the economy of that period. Us period ki economy, Rigvedic period's economy is very important. So what was the currency that was used in Rigvedic period? It is known as Nisk. ठीक है, जो करेंसी यूज होती थी उस पीरियड में उसको हम निस्क बोलते हैं, विच वॉज लाइक अ यू नो बटन और यू नो कॉइन ऑफ गोल्ड. इट वॉज मेड अप ऑफ गोल्ड. इट वॉज नोन एज निस्क. एंड देयर वॉज बार्टर सिस्टम इन द इकोनॉमी ऑफ ऋग्वेदिक पीरियड. दैट मीन्स दैट यू कैन परचेज कॉटन इन एक्सचेंज ऑफ वीट. ठीक है, तो बार्टर सिस्टम मतलब आदान प्रदान का सिस्टम था कि आपको जो चाहिए वो मैं आपको दूंगा और जो मुझे चाहिए वो आप बदले में मुझे दोगे. तो वो बार्टर सिस्टम था. एंड इन दिस सिस्टम ना काउ वॉज द इम्पोर्टेंट यूनिट ऑफ वैल्यू. सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू you know purchase something very big, very significant, you can exchange cow, right? Cow ko bhi use kar sakte the in the you know exchange system. There was no concept of private property. That means aisa nahi tha ki it's one particular piece of land belongs to one family. No, there were open lands. Anybody can come and cultivate over there. ठीक है, so because there was a you know sense of unity, brotherhood, that is why there was no private property. ऐसा नहीं है ये मेरी property है तुम्हारी, ऐसा private property का system नहीं था. आप पूरी जमीन दी हुई थी सबको, सब देख रहे थे आसपास जमीन है, कोई भी कभी भी आकर कुछ भी cultivate कर लेता था क्योंकि एक भाईचारा था, brotherhood था. ठीक है, and pastoral economy thi. It was completely a pastoral economy. Pastoral economy means when the cattle rearing activity is dominant activity. In that case we say it's a pastoral economy. And the chief measure of wealth was cattle only. Agar koi insaan kitna ameer hai, kitna gareeb, ye cattle se dekha jata tha. A person if he is rich or you know poor, it was judged based on the cattle that the person possessed. Okay, and the wealthy man was known as gomat, one who owned many cattle. तो बहुत अमीर आदमी होता था उसे गोमत कहते थे, वो इंसान जिसके पास काफी कैटल है, काफी भेड़ बकरियां हैं. The gift were exchanged between tribes which were known as prestations. तो ये prestations क्या होते थे? These were the gifts exchanged between the tribes. And they did not use iron technology. तो in the economy, iron technology was not used. So you can say because it was a pastoral economy, there was no regular revenue system also. ठीक है, so let's move forward. Now let's understand the Rigvedic religion. अब थोड़ा Rigvedic religion पढ़ लेते हैं. So we all know that when we talk about Rigvedic religion, they used to worship in open air. This question came in 2012 prelims question paper. ये question आपका religion से prelims के question paper में PYQ में आप देख सकते हो. We have solved these questions also, right? It is on my channel. You can watch the video. So they used to worship in open air. There were no temples. Temples नहीं होते थे Rigvedic religion के दौरान. वहाँ पर खुले में पूजा होती थी. They used to perform sacrifices and yagnas. They used to please the demigods, god of rain, god of fire, god of you know air. तो इन सभी demigods की पूजा की जाती थी. And the early Vedic age had no temple, no idol worship because there were no temples, there were no idols to worship. मंदिर ही नहीं थे तो मूर्तियां भी नहीं थी. सो दे यूज टू फॉलो नेचुरलिस्टिक पॉलिथिज्म. नेचुरलिस्टिक पॉलिथिज्म मींस व्हेन यू वर्शिप द नेचुरल फोर्सेस लाइक गॉड ऑफ थंडर, व्हेन यू वर्शिप वाटर, फायर, विंड, एटसेट्रा, दैट इज नोन एज नेचुरलिस्टिक पॉलिथिज्म. Okay, and the Vedic text also refer to meat eating and also the sacrificial killing of animals except the cow, because if you kill the cow, it was aganya. That means cows were the animals which were not to be killed. It is also mentioned in the Vedas. Vedas mein animals sacrifice likha hua hai ki sacrificial aap bali chadha sakte ho. Ye bhi meat eating ke bare mein bhi likha hai. But kahin bhi Vedas mein gaay ki hatya nahi likhi hui hai kyunki wo aganya hai, yani ki usko nahi maarna hai. Theek hai, it is against the the religion, the culture, the tradition. So now, dharma, there are two points that are raised in Rig Vedic religion and they were asked again in 2014 and 2012 and 11th question paper. Repeat hua hai ye questions. What is dharma? Dharma means conception of obligations and of discharge of one's duties to oneself and to others. Dharma means what are your duties according to your position and responsibility, and you need to fulfill those duties. That is known as dharma. What is reet? Reet means fundamental moral law governing functions of universe. That means reet hota hai which has been carried on since the time immemorial. For example, Ragukul reet sada chali aayi, pran jaye par vachan na jaye. Yani ki Ragukul ki ek reet chali aa rahi hai ki aap प्राण तो आप त्याग सकते हो बट आप कभी वचन से मुकर नहीं सकते, राइट? सो दैट इज रीत विच इज गेटिंग कैरिड ऑन फ्रॉम सेवरल डेकेड्स. बट धर्म मीन्स इंडिविजुअली व्हाट इज योर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी एंड यू हैव टू फुलफिल देम. दैट इज धर्म. ओके, सो हु वर द डेमी गॉड्स इन द ऋग्वेदा? फर्स्ट वॉज द गॉड इंद्रा, हु वॉज द ग्रेटेस्ट गॉड ऑफ आर्यंस. 250 हाइम्स आर एट्रीब्यूटेड टू हिम. दे आर नोन, ही इज ऑल्सो नोन एज पुरंधर, बाघवान एंड वृत्राहन, हु इज द स्लेयर ऑफ योर सेंसेस. आपके सेंसेस जो होते हैं, डिजायर्स जो होती हैं, ठीक है, उनके उनका जो स्लेयर है, जो आपकी इच्छाओं को खत्म करता है, वो है वृत्रहन. नाउ अग्नि इज द सेकंड मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट गॉड, गॉड ऑफ फायर. 200 हाइम्स, दैट मींस मंत्रास आर एट्रीब्यूटेड टू हिम. ही इज ऑल्सो द सन ऑफ अर्थ एंड हेवन एंड ही इज द इंटरमीडियरी बिटवीन गॉड्स एंड मैन. ओके, कमिंग ऑन टू वरुणा, हु इज द गॉड ऑफ पर्सोनिफाइड वॉटर. ही लुक्स आफ्टर द कॉस्मिक ऑर्डर एंड ही इज द हाइएस्ट ऑफ ऑल ऋग्वेदिक गॉड्स एथिकली. Now Soma. Soma is the god of plants, king of gods, special god of Brahmanas. He is one of the wisest god. He inspires the poets to compose hymns. And Yama is the lord of death. Then comes the another important term, god, that is Rudra. Rudra is the god who can, bring about diseases, right? And he lived in mountains and gardens of healing herbs. So diseases jo bhi hai, wo bhi create kar sakte hai, and he can heal the diseases also. He has the knowledge of all the medicines. He is, it is said that Rudra is the incarnation of Lord Shiva. Now Surya is the god who drives away darkness and Savitri is the solar deity to whom the famous Gayatri mantra is attributed. This question came in previous year question paper. Ye question aapka previous year question paper mein aaya hai. Savitri is the solar deity to whom the famous Gayatri mantra is attributed. So Rig Veda mein jo Gayatri mantra hai na, Om Bhur Bhuvah Svah Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhiyo Yonah Prachodayat. So this mantra has been dedicated to Savitri, who is the solar deity. Now coming on to the important terms which were used in Rigveda and what is the meaning of these terms. Godhuli means measure of time. When you measure time, you use the unit Godhuli. Samgava, morning. Gavyuti means measure of distance. Dohitri means the daughter who milks cow. Gotra means kinship units. Vis or Vish means clan, Gana means lineage and Gram means village. So these terms are important for prelims. Ye PYQs mein aa chuke hain previous year question papers mein. This is very important. Another is Vap. Vap means to sow the seed. Kshetra means cultivated land. Urvara means fertile land. Dhanya means cereals. Som or Sura means intoxicating drink. Ghogna means guest and Ghrita means butter. So let's, solve two of the questions. 2014's prelims question. National motto of India, Satyameva Jayate, inscribed below the emblem of India, is taken from Katha Upanishad, Chandrogay Upanishad, Aitreya Upanishad, Mandukya Upanishad. So what is the correct answer to this question? This question ka correct answer hai Mandukya Upanishad. Coming on to the next question, the dharma and reet depict a central idea of ancient Vedic civilization of India. In this context, consider the following. Now, this question was asked in 2011. Dharma was a conception of obligation and of discharge of one's duties. Reet was fundamental moral law of universe. Which statement is correct? we have just now studied, both the statements are absolutely correct. So that is why we are covering these chapters from the perspective of prelims and mains. And in my courses, I am also solving previous year question paper along with the chapters. So chapters ke saath saath, un chapters mein se jo previous year question paper mein questions aaye hain, main wo bhi solve kar rahi hoon. For example, another question, Gayatri mantra contained in Rig Veda is dedicated to Savitri, the solar deity. Okay? So, we are in this course, we are solving the questions also along with the chapters. Dekho, mains ka bhi dekh sakte ho. From mains perspective also, I give questions as homework and I also, you know, explain the answer to the students so that they can write, you know, accordingly. And then I evaluate their answers also. Main unke answers ko bhi evaluate karti hoon. So, this is how we are teaching and we are taking classes and the PDF is also available to the students. Class ka jo PDF hai na, wo bhi students ko hum dete hain. So that they can download them and use them in the time of revision. So if you think, if you enjoyed this class, this is a glimpse of how I teach on Unacademy Plus. If you enjoyed it, do not forget to subscribe to Unacademy Plus and use this code SHARMA20 to get 10% discount as well. Thank you.